Wade's speech is entitled Reflections on Pathways from Pathways Visionary Communication. The purpose of his speech is to guide us through a path from the beginning to the end. He will recap his personal journey through the pathways and give us hints and tips and tricks that we might use on our own personal pathways journey. Jennifer, this is a 10 to 12 minute speech, and let us all welcome Wade Johnson.
Excellent, thank you, Madam Toastmaster. Let me try to share my screen because this is a presentation. Are you all seeing my presentation okay?
Definitely.
Excellent. Thank you.
Very good.
Tell me about you. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters, this was the question that used to absolutely terrify me, stump me during interviews back in 2016 when I first joined Toastmasters. The educational track at the time was manual-based. You had two manuals, competent communication and the competent leadership role. Everybody would go through these manuals, and then after you were done, you would pay for an advanced manual. For me, at the time, I just wanted to get through an interview without fumbling through my own career profile. But I lacked the confidence to speak in front of people. I eventually did land a job, a good job. So, goal accomplished. Enough table topics, evaluations, speeches. You'll learn how to slow your roll, breathe, and just do what you already know how to do. Toastmasters International, though, had a problem. Much of the educational track hadn't been updated since the 1970s. And when looking at who finished what, it was found that less than 10% of people actually finished a CC, or competent communication manual, 2% for a CL, competent leadership, and then just 1% of folks actually moved on to an advanced manual. Enter in pathways. Once rolled out, we as a club had 2 years to make the switch. Essentially, if you're working towards something like your DTM, your Distinguished Toastmasters, you are now given a deadline for the completion. Oh, and the old educational credits that you got didn't transfer over to the new system. For me, I was in it for about a year, year and a half, and I was well into both of the manuals. But I had no strong desire to become a DTM or a, you know, certified public speaker of any type. So the switch was easy. I did my online assessment, picked visionary communication, and I was off and running. I was also the VP of public relations right about this time. And not being a marketing guy, I had a lot to learn. Having achieved gainful employment, my primary purpose for joining Toastmasters in the first place was achieved. I needed a new goal. Part of my vision was to transform the club's image from what it was to what it is. And apologies for the graphic here. It was the only old logo that I could find. But essentially, it was busy with too many colors. And when you think of a logo, you should all think of a stamp. If you can't stamp it, cut it out. So first and foremost, designed the new logo. Still a little bit busy, but at least it has that stamp quality. It's much more clean, it's two-toned, and it fits with our nautical theme of helmsman. there is a lot more to VP of public relations and branding of the club, but I won't go into it for sake of time. I did take a special interest to YouTube and how do we get more views and promote ourselves in the video sense. For me, like if I have a question or a problem, YouTube is my go-to source. Pretty much you go and ask YouTube anything, they're gonna give you an answer. Somebody has done it somewhere and posted it online. The analogy I like to use is that I absolutely love cake, but I love cupcakes better. I don't even have to break out a knife. But what's really, really dangerous is those little mini cupcakes. I can find myself often hours later having watched just little bite-sized pieces of video, spending the night on YouTube. I wanted to translate that somehow into us, into Helmsman. How do we get those bite-sized elements that people actually want to view? Now, one of the major tips that I will give is perfection is the enemy of progress. I've fallen into this trap many times. I don't want to come off bad, and I want it to be perfect. I want perfect lighting and the perfect graphics and the perfect contrast and everything. I get bogged down into the details, and I've scrapped so much just because it didn't meet my high level of perfection. So I'll say this. Post. Make the mistakes. That's what we're here for. Learn as you go along. Try different settings each time. That's why we joined Toastmasters in the first place. Now, because we are Toastmasters and we should be able to take some constructive criticism, let me quickly tell you about my view on the Pathways rollout and the Pathways interface. It's a disaster. Definitely not the most friendly of sites for those that have poked around. And this is largely due to the fact that Toastmasters.org does not behave like the rest of the internet. There is a rule in web design that's called the three-click rule. Every web designer learns this on day one. As the name suggests, you have three clicks. Beyond that, your user is going to get frustrated and leave. Toastmasters International breaks this rule of navigation all over the place. And let me get out of my presentation and give you a quick example. I go into Toastmasters. I want to check a path. So let me go into my base camp. This is Google remembering my username and password, not Toastmasters, but that's okay. I've already said I wanted to go to Basecamp. I've already put my username and password in. Now I have to go into Basecamp again. Okay, now I have to find my pathway. I have to open the curriculum and go to wherever I'm going. I have to click on the level, and then I have to launch the particular level or project that I'm trying to do. If you're taking count, that's seven clicks. Seven. Now, in contrast, let me go into Amazon. When I go into Amazon, notice it already remembers me. I type in something I want to do, lights. Boom. I click on the light and I can buy now. That's two clicks. It might have me re-authenticate myself if I actually want to purchase this, but case in point. Let me go back to my presentation. Now, know that if you're clicking around Toastmasters International and you're frustrated, it's not you, really. And this is coming from somebody with a computer science background and considers himself very much a techie. I love this stuff, but Toastmasters should really take a look at what they promote, which is learn from your mistakes. It's okay, try again. Not to let Toastmasters off the hook. This is not easy stuff. Having developed a couple apps and worked through user interfaces for years, I don't envy them. Everyone's a critic and completely oblivious to how difficult coding to simplicity really is. A lesson to the rest of us, learn from your mistakes. It's okay, it's what we're here for. Now, back to pathways. It's good, it's really good. You got 11 different paths to choose from, 300 unique competencies, recognition comes a lot earlier and more frequently. And there's a lot, a lean towards tech, to video and projects that actually relate to the 21st century. And it still sticks to its primary purpose of being a speaking and leadership organization. Now, having already worked through my path and starting another path, the levels within the path of mastering fundamentals, level one is, from what I can tell, is always the same. You do your icebreaker, evaluation and feedback, and then a research and presenting type of role. After that, it kind of breaks away and starts to dive into the path that you actually chose. And then level three is really where the projects start to kick off and become more project-based, as well as you get a lot more electives to choose from to hone in on your particular path that you've chosen. And now this is similar to level four and level five. If speeches are your thing, there are a ton of electives within the level three, four, and five electives that you can just do many, many times without actually repeating any of them. Now, the last suggestion I can give is you've picked a path for a reason. Coaching, mentoring, leadership, whatever. My suggestion is create a brand for yourself, like I did for Helmsman. You've gone through your path, and as you go through it, you're gonna build these assets. You're gonna create the logos, the schema, the font colors, the everything to make you you, your own brand identity. You'll learn what you like, what you don't, what works, what doesn't. And in the end, when somebody asks you the question of, tell me about you, you won't freeze. Madam Toastmaster, back to you.
If you like this video, please subscribe to Helmsman 770. Thank you.